Fran, did you get samples?
I have a lot.
Take whatever you want.
Okay.
So you see what you do is you lift it just long enough to let that level travel under it. Always let go before and let it go over the bump on its own, and then it'll drop in the right place. It gets more difficult here. You should automatically progress to that. If it doesn't, you're only holding up for a split second. And so it is a little tricky to do that. I wish this hadn't happened. Yeah, then you just went off.
Are those two brands?
Yeah, they're emergency brakes, one for each other. However, one for that motor is all right, one for this motor is poorly engineered, and they have stops to them. They'll never travel. So. Okay, so we'll take a look in here.
So,
can you see it very well?
Yeah. Okay, so you just let it go.
Yeah. Penalty for holding it too long is kind of a range of problems with the least offensive of which is that you skip the second and draw one across the lead, or you skip the first part and the next part and the last part.
What's coming out of the size of the scratch?
Somebody has intentionally scratched the drill at some point.
So nothing's falling and going
now? No.
Fran,
what do you make of this thing?
Dressed in a sort of a green velvet woman, her
that where they got the green
French poems were in the mail form.
Mm-hmm.
You had a name for the green something like
that. It was the Green Lady. It was called the Green Lady here for ages. Since its debut in the 1930s, I think. Until it was reassigned. This poem is done with the wink of the eye, you know, it's a very mischievous poem. The sort of deliberate aspects of its moves make it very secure in its talent.
So that last cam is just basically saying this is written by.
Well, he's doing all this embellishment. He's putting an interior frame, and then he's signing.
Yeah. Now it's resetting the whole way back.
Yeah, that's right. It returns to its starting position, so the transverse motor runs continuously for.
It's not all the way over.
It should be.
As much as you can see of each spring.
It
doesn't
expect so long,
too. Yeah, sure.
Still think we can engage everything. I still think we can make a. I can't do it myself, but mm-hmm. There's a place in England that we've used that custom makes springs.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a long process, it's an expensive process, mm-hmm. but they're fantastic.
And it's nice to know that option exists.
So it's there, mm-hmm. And there's also errors within the springs that you can go. These may be mm-hmm. Shorter, very powerful springs, or very thick springs to get the power that they needed at the time.
I think they're thick.
And we can go with a thinner spring that provides mm-hmm. the same amount of torque. Mm-hmm. And
the next obstacle is to make sure that the slot in the glass doesn't get bashed. It has obviously been before. And all the other thing is when you get this far, the bottom edge of the glass tends to want to catch on that edge, so it helps to keep a little elevation. The other thing, and this is major, I forgot to do it, is pay attention to where the pen tip is, because if you're holding this a little higher, you're going to really put a hell of a strain on the arm.
Discussion with him about how they do that in a responsible way. And in some cases, some of the automata that he worked on is as old, if not older, than Henri Maillardet's automata. So I'll report back to you on that. I'll be back. Now, Mr. Quarterman, please collect quarters from everybody.
Don't get out of the cigar box.
Can we pump it up to like 50 cents?
No.
2014.
These are special people. Anyhow, I'll be back in a few minutes, okay?
Chief. Okay. You give it a turn or so.
Or
to just need to get a feel for it. Yeah.
Are we filming?
Yep.
I'm not wearing gloves.
Sorry, I think relatively few demonstrators have worn a glove. The hand oils enhanced it.
I don't want to see in the okay, so I'm sorry. Clockwise?
Yes.
How much do you want to add?
I guess I can do that.
A turn of chamber, so bring it at least once around.
One turn.
Everybody else wants to get you to feel what that feels like. That's maybe you should
do. That is incredibly heavy.
Yeah.
That's only halfway charged. That's only halfway around.
Yeah.
Wow, who wants to get good?
One of the specs that I captured on some previous visit was how much winding does it take to get through a full program. And basically, the rotational motor that you're winding down will be depleted at just about just shy of the full 7 programs. So we can assume that the springs haven't lost too much and probably that they were calibrated to get the whole program on one full wind, which is pretty remarkable as that seems to be intentional.
That would go hand in hand with having the reservoir pen and just having it run through.
A woman in 1802, writing to her niece, commented that the most remarkable thing about it is that it does what it, you know, it will do a complete drawing without any invention. And so I think she was talking about not the fact that it runs, you know, for 4 minutes. The transverse motor will last much longer than one. I don't know what the spec is, maybe 2.5 to 3 full programs. It depletes much more slowly. Because it's only running.
Siri not available. Connected.
Calibrates the height. This is a ball joint, ball and socket joint at the wrist. So this little raised dimple I haven't seen before, but obviously as a result of my resurfacing the tips last June, I advised something like 2 business card thicknesses. And if the pen is set too high, it misses lines. If it's set too low, you get retrace lines and things you shouldn't see. That should be just about right. Thanks.
top. I have no idea if we're in the middle of this election or we're about to start one. This isn't calibrated right.
So we can just turn them all off.
We can't use that at this point, so we have to make kind of a,
do our best.
Not too far. It's getting lighter. Let's see if that'll do it. Yeah, maybe it is the pen. It's
much, yeah.
Yeah, it's starting to flow. The banner on the mast of the ship. Getting a lighter touch that side, which is why they had shims in there. But
so smooth.
See, now shit automatically progress, obviously.
Not shifting.
First motor to kick on, which move down.
It's not
next.
It's
because nobody put the cord in
there. It's because somebody got in there and moved the vanes on the governor's when I wasn't looking.
I saw that they were shifted around.
Yeah.
You said that they were pretty much perpendicular.
Well, they were. I have to. What I need to do is capture.
There it goes.
He's been doing this for more than two centuries.
Fran, there are so many variations in the z-axis that you can't even see going on. I mean, I'm looking at all the little changes that are in there, but you don't see the pen or anything. I could be getting lost in the mechanical.
Now I'm looking at undulations in the first, second, third cam of the z-axis.
Uh-huh.
So that suggests varying pen tip pressure.
Yeah.
See?
Oh, it shifted. Okay.
So he not only draws these portholes, but he stops to put a little cannon in each one.
I actually first discovered this totally by accident. My last name being Winship, I was looking at ship drawings and came across
this one
years ago in a book.
Oh, no. Wow. Yeah, I see the left hand occasionally moves. He did not want to spoil the illusion, you know, having just this dead weight hanging there would make it look less alive. So it's a subtle thing, but it makes all the difference. This is what he was after. Yeah, somebody said, does it make any noise? And the only time it actually makes a noise, a natural noise, not the spring shutter, is when it's drawing the needles on the pine tree on the Chinese temple. As the bumps go under this. So that was missed two, got one.
that, that's that. And these lines are unnatural to the ship. Most of the drawings have some people in the little lanterns. And he's putting the emblem in the flag there.
On the roofs?
Yeah. I wonder if that's the crewman that he drew up there first before the balloons. I think by now he'd be able to do it just from muscle memory. Waves on the ocean like the last. Don't forget to look at him looking at himself now and then. Anchor.
Doink. It's going again.
Yeah, well, we're going to abort this one.
Okay.
Is this the one that has the fail?
Yeah, this one actually went ahead in the programming. It's needing work. I wish it had.
These followers are not identical.
No, they're not.
And the camp followers.
Oh, no.
They are.
It's different.
Yeah. That?
That's the springs.
Oh, the shattering.
Yeah, now that's happening earlier on now, probably because precisely because I've said to keep at least three turns. Now it's moving up as the next round of springs are sticking together. So that's
incredible. It could also be surface tension.
That was not as violent as it can be.
We heard some worse ones in June.
Yeah.
Yeah, because, I mean, just liquid would create surface tension. You may not want to let go, and the viscosity would change.
But I'm sure there's gummy old oil in those barrels.
Yeah, well, it's going to be like cement almost.
I've wound enough bracket clothes to feel it cut loose.
This one missed the first track.
That was the missing part.
Yeah, it's missing about 2/3 of its advancing views. It's missing parts of its visuals. So this one, and I can see it's a fail. It's shifted over to.
It's sorted up pretty nice.
Yeah, it's it's out of sequence. The starts and stops are way off.
Oh, as far as whether it's on the first?
Yeah, it's the last drawing of this one. This one felt the same as the last. I thought I was holding up the lever too long because it stopped immediately when I let go, but there's some synchronization problems.
Is that the larger gap than the smaller gap on the seat right here?
No, just so I can get a little bit of it.
For distribution.
No, they do. Right.
Sometimes you will find that the cues get better just with the running order. Which is logical.
So what is it? What's the purpose of this
This is probably counterbalance.
It is kind of. It is.
It is for sound.
Yeah, Andy said it, but I think that there's the degree of to which it can set the counter spring for the y-axis compensator. It's pretty specific. So I do think it has to do largely with the pen that it used to have. Doing the temple.
I mean, if you look at it, they're no smaller than the lowest points of some of, like that one right in there. You know, mm-hmm. It's very similar to that.
This one seems to be doing just fine.
Yeah, I can't believe this thing.
This one rings better than the one that you sent me, Andy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was satisfied. See, but maybe this one's all right. Maybe this thing is nice. I have not memorized.
Who has tickets to the
what's it for?
Parking.
Oh, I didn't know that.
There's the little...
I just park on the street. I mean, that's why I put on an L.
Wow.
That's all right. Do that.
Oh, wow.
Fran?
Huh?
That one branch, right?
You know, you're right. You couldn't
do this by yourself.
I don't think there's any stone on this edge. Small. What to do next? Okay, I know.
One oddball line there.
Well, each one has
different
more information.
Yeah.
Give it its sort of exponential. Like that, he's filling in the diamond pattern inside the columns now.
Yeah.
It does look better, Fran.
Oh, you did? Yeah. So I don't need to get it.
Oh, yeah. Chinese hat.
Waterfowl.
So there's really...
It's working actually very well.
Very well.
The Westminster discovery of the drawings, that's the only evidence.
And that's a little oddball line there.
As far as I know, but I haven't attempted direct communication with him. Or
Andy,
yeah.
That rendering's a lot better than the one you sent me. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the face is still a scribble. I can see the little... frown of a mouth and a giant eyeball.
Well, I think that those details of the two eyes, nose, and mouth is—it's just one little like that, and the rhythm and the z-axis. So it's just a quick little and a quick.
What we need to do someday is stop it right before that
and walk it through.
Look at what's about to come under the follower tip.
Yeah.
You know, there's just tons of stuff. This is the first of its French poems. This is the more legible one of the two, and this is the one that has that beautiful message about the desire to please you begot this one.
To
He does. It's almost remarkable to watch him write as it is to watch him write.
I think so.
There aren't as many surprises, but it is such an elegant.
Ooh.
It was an interesting sound.
I heard a spring.
Yeah, it didn't sound like the usual moon spring. No, the cues are good.
Looks like it just needed to move a little bit.
I think that was definitely a spring.
It sounded like spring chatter.
Yeah. Sounded more rattly.
Well, they're wound down pretty far.
Yeah,
down, so.
Put some more power on
it.
I was going to say,
yeah, maybe aim for a larger motion, unless it has just done it, what it's going to do.
little spring fart.
I think it did, it's kind of incrementally, because that last one wasn't as big as the one before, but it had one earlier that wasn't as big, so the two of them were combined. Now this oval is smaller than the one around the going, and so it's manageable.
That's it.
Should we wind up a little more?
Yeah, go ahead.
Give it a crank.
The gremlins have been over again. No wonder it feels so sticky at this end. This is all had a bunch of, it looks like white lithium grease, but it's hard and sticky. Some slop on the sidewall here. This is what happens every time. I'm surprised. I've never seen grease put there before. Somebody can't because of
it. I wondered, you said that.
Yeah, I wondered why.
You said that in your speech, you said that when you originally got the cams open and found some. You thought it was oil, and it was hardened. You tried to scrape it away. You think that when they originally had put the thing together and polished up all the inners, that they might have lacquered the whole interior, and it might be lacquer on the sides, because there's a surprising lack of any patina on the sides. Yeah, I expect them to be dark brown.
What I've noticed this time is this. The index lever doesn't feel right at all. And it's sticky, it's grabby, and it should absolutely not have any.
Yeah, you can put some oil on it. It'll be fine for a few months until the oil gets sticky. Yeah. And then the levers start to stick. And I'm sure you've experienced it too many times. You pull the lever off to get the oil off of it. And also, the lacquer on the top had two functions.
In general,
one is to prevent the tarnishing and fingerprints and things on it, but also lacquer surfaces and cloths, they started doing that because oil doesn't travel over a lacquer surface, so it has a mechanical value as well. But when we redo a cloth that was originally lacquer, we peg the holes in every lacquer in place. You take a polished piece of glass and put oil in it, and it just spreads out.
It's like surface tension. The surface tension of the oil
stays in place, and that's mostly why you lacquer an instrument.
Anyway, so it's another cleaning job. In other words, that will need to be done maybe in October when I come back, if there's interest from the institute. Oh, it's really sticky. Oh, it's really stiff, sticky grease. I don't know what it came out of, but
it's new. Does it feel new?
Yeah, it's new. It's new since last June. See that? Maybe there's some on the edge of the engraved wheel here.
Step before the peak, and it's so sticky and grabby. I can't tell what it's doing. And
you can see it all over the end of the.
Yeah, the little bit I scraped off here, it's really stiff and sticky.
Bronze inserts? In that time period? Bronze inserts?
It certainly could be.
Is that what I see right there? Is that a bronze insert?
Looks like bronze.
It's sort of the main shaft.
That could have been, that could very well have been part of the 1980 work.
Yeah, that would be my first guess, is that that's a later edition.
Mm-hmm, I think so. The original is probably just the brass itself.
Yeah. It's not real common to find brass bushing or bronze bushing.
It's doing some fine work.
Where was this one?
On the manager of the workshop, Maillardet, was Swiss, and he employed, I imagine, several people. And he was also charged with housing and feeding them. They all lived in the same house with him.
Kind of chased out of where it was before. He kind of sort of.
Well, not necessarily. I haven't read anything that says that, but he certainly was inspired by his time and builder contemporaries, at least the Henri Maillardet himself.
Thank you.
And is there any information directly from him?
We have only half of conversations. We have letters in response to comments from him, but we don't have his originals. I think they were so agitating that they were destroyed or just lost. Anything doesn't get kept.
Let's come on. It's stopped. Okay. Yeah, these fins are almost.
What about?
They're like 45 degrees off.
Harrison. PBS special.
Yeah, I'm familiar with Longitude, and also Rupert Gold.
And Harrison, the clocks he made, and his H1, H2, and those things. He very much knew at the end of his life that his clocks were going to be cherished and end up in museums. And he also pretty specifically said he wanted them running. Mm-hmm. And he didn't want them sitting there idle, which, to my knowledge, now they are finally. They've remade them.
Right.
And,
yeah.
I'm thinking of K5, but that was early. That was January 1. It's K4. K4 was a copy of H4. Was there an H5?